Yes, it shall. Welcome to the day after Christmas. I trust it was fine for you. The Christmas was fine for you. Well, then today, you're supposed to be boxing around. May you be able to do. Our truth this morning is on the truth is invincible. And that's coming from 2 Corinthians chapter 13, from 8 to the end. You are warmly welcome to the Really, Really Knowing God channel. I am Pastor Larry Adenekon. It's all packed to inform and inspire you into a real knowledge of the living God. Everything being powered by the Pastor Larry Adenekon Center for Eduspiration, the place. This is the Daily Gem Devotional, making you a gem to your generation and a gemstone upon the crown of our Lord Jesus Christ. Now, if you are done with spiritual chocolate and now you want a balanced diet, this is the place to be. Let us pray. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we give you thanks, God, especially at this season, for the things we have remembered and we have meditated upon and all this season. Lord God, we give you all the praise and all the glory. As we do our bit this morning on this YouTube channel, we receive your help, God, at it in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, and give your people a blessing special for this occasion for today. Thank you, Heavenly Lord. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. Amen. Okay, verse 8 now. For we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. For we are glad when we are weak and you are strong. This also we pray, that you may be made complete. Therefore, I write these things, being absent, lest being present I should use sharpness, according to the authority which the Lord has given me, for edification and not for destruction. Okay, let's pause and say one or two things. For we can do nothing against the truth, but for the truth. That is a big statement as far as this ministry is concerned. It's all about truth. And the Bible says in here, we can actually do nothing against the truth. In other words, when you orchestrate, when you machinate against the truth, when you arise and try to suppress the truth or do whatever, you are sure to fail, because there's nothing anybody can do about the truth. It's constant, and it's something that is, you cannot defeat it. You cannot push it off. You cannot do anything about the truth. What am I talking about? Truth here is God stands on any matter. God backs that stance, you know, that he has on each particular matter. And there's nothing anyone can do about it. That's what he's saying. So if you are able to identify the truth on any particular matter, you know that your standing is sure. Hallelujah. Whereas if you do not, you are going to enter into bondage, because it says you will know the truth and the truth will make you free. You fail to know the truth, you remain bound. That is what it implies. You remain bound. You are cornered by some other things other than the truth. But you see, there's nothing we can do against the truth. That is what the Bible teaches us here. And it is important to know this thing and to identify with the truth and to apply the truth in all that you do. You will know the truth, and the truth shall make you a free person. The liberty of God will operate in your life when the truth is operating in your life. Concerning any matter, understand the truth, stand by it, stick to it, it's going to win. Hallelujah. It's as powerful as saying love never fails. It's as powerful as that. The truth will always win. It's unstoppable and it will always win. Hallelujah. Paul went on to say something very interesting. We are glad when we are weak and you are strong. And this also we pray, that you may be made complete. Like we said the other time, Paul was somebody who, as far as he was concerned, ministry was all about transformation in the lives of the people to whom you are ministering. Now, if you consider us to be weak, we are fine, as long as you are strong. Hallelujah. If you consider us to be, we are not eloquent, we are ineloquent, but you are good, that's fine by us. You are fine, you are strong, you are doing well in the Lord, that's fine by us. Whichever way you look at it, we are prepared to be weak in Christ, that the power of Christ may be made manifest through us towards you to make you strong. That's it. If you are strong, we are fine. We are just fine. And I like that. The Spirit is really, really wonderful and necessary, really, that it's all about the people of God. It's not about us. Of course, we bear all kinds of big names. We, you know, we are man of God, father in the Lord, general. What's the other name? That we bear all kinds of names. But you see, the Bible makes us to understand that it is about the people of God. It's about his household. That's what God really, really cares about. We are but servants in the house of God, and we must be faithful faithful, as we read in that 24th chapter of Matthew or something, that a servant must be faithful. That's when the Lord is going to say, well done, you know, good and faithful servant. He says, so he says, we also pray that you may be made complete. Complete means here complete or mature, or at a proper height, or at a full stature, you know, the case may be, fully grown, whatever. And that's why he was saying the other time, I fear lest I will come and I will be humbled. Present day language, humiliated, to find that some of you are still living in sin. If I find some of you still living in sin, it implies that I'm a failure. You know, that's what we said the other time. And Paul was saying, all we are after is that you will be complete by the grace of God. You will be mature. You will have attained certain height. That's what we are all about. In terms of name calling and everything, call us all kinds of names, any name you want to call us, as long as you are complete, as long as you are fine, as long as you are doing just fine in the things of the kingdom, as long as God will hug you, you know, on that last day, we don't mind. You can call us names, you can say whatever it is you want to say. Honestly, this is a great spirit and I love that. Hallelujah. It says that's what we are working towards, that's where we are praying for. It says the other place in Colossians, he says, I'm striving that we may present every man perfect before Christ. That same word perfect, complete, here they're talking about the same thing. God help us in Jesus' mighty name. It says, therefore I write these things being absent, lest being present, I should use sharpness according to the authority, you know, which God, the Lord, has given me for edification and not for destruction. He says, I'm writing these things ahead that you would have already repented before I arrive, so that by the time I come, I will not be hard on anyone. Remember, he said earlier on, I don't want to come and I meet you the way I don't like, or you see us the way you don't like. I don't want that. I want us to meet such that everybody will be excited to see one another. You'll be willing to give me beautiful testimonies, and I also will be proud, smiling and glorifying God on account of you when I see you. And that's why I'm writing these letters. I want a lot of things to have been corrected before I arrive. I don't want to come and I have to be hard on people. I want people to have worked upon themselves before I arrive. Praise God. He said, and then he says something about the authority the Lord has given them, which I like, for today, for edification and not for destruction. Whatever it is we do, it must build the people. Of course, Paul says they are not for destruction. That is the other end of it. But between edification and the other end of it, there are some other things in the middle. Like what, for example? Like when people are stagnant, that's not what God has given you the authority for. That when the people are stunted, that's not what God has given you the authority. They are not yet destroyed, but they are stunted. They are stagnant. They are not moving. Okay, that's not what God gave you the authority for. It's to build up, it's to edify. Edify simply means building. Nobody builds up in a stagnant way. That's no building. Nobody, I mean, so when you are running some teaching, some ministry that is not allowing the people to grow, they are stagnant, they are stunted, they are not any people that God can be proud of, you know, or God can flaunt, like he was flaunting Job, then you are not doing the job. Honestly, you are not really doing the job. Paul says that the Lord has given us for edification. Destruction may not yet be your portion, and we glorify God for that. Praise God. We glorify, but when the people are not growing, when they are stunted, when their values are the wrong values, when they are tilting towards the way of the world, you are not doing the job. God help us in Jesus' name. Finally, greeted, brethren, farewell, goodbye. You know, and then it says, become complete. Remember, he said that one earlier on in verse 9. He says, pray that you may be mature, you may be complete. And then it says, become complete, grow, be mature. Hallelujah. Be perfect. That's what he was saying there. Amen. Be of good comfort. Be of one mind. Live in peace, and the God of love and peace will be with you. Be of one mind. Be of good comfort. Comfort one another. Okay. And the Lord will be with you. Greet each other with an holy kiss. You know the way they greeted each other? You know, they kiss the cheeks and all the rest of you. Part of their culture. Not so much our culture here. But anyway, it's there are some cultures that are good to learn. Some other ones, you may just leave them. If you don't want that, no wahala. But you have your own, our own form of it. Do the same thing here that amounts to greeting people and greeting them heartily. Okay. In some other culture, they will not greet. That's the way they move their hand and touch their chest to let you know that this greeting is from my heart. Whichever one is your own, do it and let it be hearty by the grace of God. All the saints around here salute you. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Amen. That's the one we call the grace. Okay. Praise the Lord. Well, then it's not so called in the Bible, but if we choose to So christen it, let it be. No problem. As long as you apply meaning to it when you are reading it, you are not just when you are reciting, you are not just saying it for saying sake, you are saying it with meaning and understanding, it's okay. It's a good prayer. The Lord bless you, and I greet you as well. It's a day they say the people box around. Please do a bit of boxing as well and bless somebody's life by the grace of God. God bless you. Thank you very much one more time. Merry Christmas.